Hey folks, David Frost, LazyGapTrader.com. In this video, I'm going to show you the single best day trading strategy there is. In this video, we're going to go over three stocks using what I call a gap fill strategy, and I'm going to show you a heartbreaker where a morning gap trade, and I'll explain what that is when we get there, missed by 4 cents. And I left $4 on the table in a matter of minutes. So we'll get to that last. But in this trade, Activision Blizzard, ATVI is the symbol, I'm going to show you how you can make money when you can identify a stock that's going to fill a gap and likely have a reaction off that gap fill. This is exactly what I teach in my course. I teach you which stocks this works the best with, what type of stocks to look for, what the characteristics are, and best of all, I teach you which ones to stay away from and which particular gap fills to stay away from because they're less likely to work. So let's take a look at Activision. Here's a stock where it was filling the gap. Now you would say, well, how did you know this is the red line is $30.53? And you would say, how did you know that that was the level where the stock was going to stop rising and start to pull back from? Well, what I do is I take my gap trades generally off the 60-minute chart. And you can see here on the 60-minute chart, on the 5th of February, the stock closed at $30.53. The next day, it gapped lower, opening at $29.70. That left open a gap that at some point in time is likely to get filled. So $30.53 is my price that I'm willing to sell this stock short at in order to get a reaction off of this resistance level. So let's go back to the 10-minute chart and see what happens when the stock hits $30.53. On this candle here, we had a high of $30.53. This candle, it went slightly higher and hit $30.55. But just about an hour later, the stock was at a low of $30.13. Now, it's not a huge trade, but it's 36 cents inside of an hour if you're trading 1,000 shares, that's $360. If you waited just a little bit longer, the stock went even lower. You could have got over 50 cents. What if you were trading 2,000 shares or 1,500 shares? Any amount. A profit is a profit. Let's look at the next stock, which is Amazon. So Amazon is filling a gap today, just like Activision was. And what happened was we pierced through a gap left open by the stock opening significantly lower just a couple of days ago. So you would say, again, at $502.10, how did you know that was the level that the stock was likely to start pulling back from? Well, let's go back to the hourly chart again, and you'll see where I got it from. You see here on the 5th of February, the closing price was $502.10. That's exactly the price where my line is, $502.10. Let's go back to the 10-minute chart and see what happened when the stock got up there. So the stock is trading higher. It got a little bit through $502.10, hitting a high of $504.66. Now you might say, well, how do I know the stock's not going to keep going? We have specific parameters that I teach in the course on how much leeway to give a stock if it's trading through the level we're looking to short it at or through the level we're looking to buy it at. In this case, we were within the parameters, and look what happened next. Just within the hour, the stock was down, hitting a low of $492.70. That's about a $10 gain in just over an hour off of a gap fill trade. Again, just over an hour, $10 gain on Amazon. This was another trade in the same day. Now let's look at the third trade today of a gap fill of Hartford Financial. HIG is the symbol. Here's again the 10-minute chart, and you can see my line is at $40.54. Now where did I come up with that level? Let's go back to the hourly chart where you can see on February 5th, okay, the stock closed at $40.54. That's where my line is. Let's go back to the 10-minute chart. The stock is trading higher. We come right up to the level, pierced through it by a little bit. We hit a high of $4.67. again, well within the stop loss parameters that I teach in the course. And then what happened? Just over an hour later, the stock is all the way down at $39.79. How about a 75 cent gain in just over an hour? Maximum gain, that is. So these are the type of gap fill trades that I teach you how to select them, how to play them correctly, how to understand how much risk to take, how to understand where to take the profit off the table, and also I teach how to turn a trade like this into a risk-free trade after you've got some profit so that you can maximize the gain and end up with the stock down here towards the end of the day while still having some of the position left. Now, real quick, I have to show you the heartbreaker. This was out of the morning gaps. What I do in my morning gaps is I teach traders how to identify levels where a stock that's gapping significantly lower at the open or significantly higher, I teach you how to identify the level where that stock should find support or resistance within pennies. And what happened today, if we go to the longer time frame, what happened today is you can see here that I had identified a level of $86.21. Now realize that Disney closed yesterday at $92.41. It opened today at $88. That's a $4 gap down, or almost $4.50 gap down, and it kept going. And I had a level picked out at $86.21. Unfortunately, what happened was the stock hit a low today of $86.25 in that first 10-minute candle. Let's go back to the 10-minute chart, and you'll see what happened. As soon as it hit that level, missed my fill by 4 cents. The stock took off higher, and in just a matter of basically an hour, the stock was up at $90.03 off that level. I didn't get filled, unfortunately. Somebody did. That one's a heartbreaker, but you can see how precise this is. Sometimes that happens where you won't get filled, but just think about it. Had the stock dropped another 4 or 5 cents, I would have been filled and had a $4 gain inside of an hour. Or how about in the first 10 minutes, the stock even hit a high of $89 off that level. So this is just an example of the morning gap trades. And this is also what I teach in my course. I teach the morning gap trades and I teach how to do the gap fill trades. This is a very, very profitable day trading strategy. I want you to come over to lazygaptrader.com and learn how to do this for yourself. It's the most profitable, best, and successful day trading strategy I know of. I'm David Frost. Thanks for tuning in, folks.